is the mindset challenge is all about rain. When you think of rain, what do you think of? I think of refresh, calm. I wrote some words down here so I wouldn't forget them all. You wash away the worries. You cleanse the soul. You renew yourself. You break down barriers and you refresh. And I find it very soothing and calming. Even when it's pounding down on top, you know, torrential downpours and all of that, I still find a calmness in it. I don't know what it is about downpouring of rain, but to me it's a very soothing sound, a very calming sound. So today I want you to think all about rain and the benefits it can bring. Because years ago I learned there's nothing, no matter how much I bitch and moan about the weather, nothing's going to change it. The weather is what it is. It's going to do what it's going to do. So you may as well find ways to relax and enjoy it. So I found ways to relax and enjoy rain by finding it soothing and calming, helps break down barriers, found it very refreshing. There's just days that it just makes you want to snuggle up into something warm and read a good book. So think about all the benefits that rain can have on your mind, with its soothing sounds, the things it can wash away, breaks down barriers, you know, torrential downpours. I'm still trying to figure that one out, but I find it very soothing and calming for some reason. It doesn't get me uptight, like, is it going to come through the roof? Is my ceiling going to leak? Especially being in an RV, am I going to leak? I've got my seals now fixed, so no, we're not. But you know, think of the ways that rain can benefit your mindset. Think of it cleansing, soothing, calming, all those nice little words. And then for your business challenge, it's all about routine. Right now, everybody's out of routine. You know, we're on this giant global pause, and we've been talking about this for a week. If you want to go check out my Facebook feed, there is a link to my blog that I wrote about, you know, a time to pause. And we're right now in a global pause. So a lot of people's routines have been thrown out of whack. They're losing track of days. So start today with setting up a routine. Find a way to get a routine, even in these, you know, turmoil times. You're stuck at home. You're having to work from home for the first time. You're not sure how to do it. You're not coping with it very well. Get yourself into a routine. We have a routine here. I actually set 2 alarms in case I oversleep. And I usually wake up before the first one goes off. But my first alarm I used to set to come and get Zeffy out of her crate. Well, she now sleeps on the bed with me, so I don't need to worry about that one. But that's sort of like my wake up if I happen to, and I happen to oversleep that one today. But that was just the time to get in bed and just stretch out those sore muscles from my fall the other day. And I am a little sore from the other day, yep, from my fall 2 days ago. Sore than I was yesterday, but not as sore as I expected, which is a good thing because I was stretching and moving a lot yesterday. So it was a chance to stretch out all those kinks and everything, just lay in bed and snuggle up with Zeffy and just read for a little bit. And then when the second alarm goes off, that's time to get up. And Zeffy seems to know this routine very well, because as soon as that second alarm goes off, she's off the bed. She races down, puts her nose out the window now, and then she comes back and starts whining at me as I say, come on, let's get up, let's get moving, come on. She'll even try it before the second alarm goes off. But you get into the routines of doing things, and the routines will help you set your days and help you keep track of days as well. Because start putting the stuff into your calendars and blocking out certain times, but only put into the calendars the stuff you are committed to doing. Don't put stuff in the calendars for the sake of putting stuff in the calendars. Put stuff in the calendars that you are committed to doing. And then your fun challenge today is all about pen and paper. What can you create with pen and paper? You know, you can do things like games like Noughts and Crosses, Hangman, Dots, SOS. What's that one that we used to do? Oh, the storyline one, where you would write one line of a story and fold over the previous line. So you'd all start off with one line at the top, and you'd pass it to the person next to you. They would see that line, and then they would write a line to that, and then they would fold over that first line. So when they pass the piece of paper on, the person can only see the line that they wrote, that was written by the person before them. They can't see what was written before that. Makes for very interesting stories when that comes out. That was one of my favorite games growing up, was the story game. You could also use it for, like, you know, a Pictionary type game. You know, use it to draw pictures and, you know, like a charades, but make it Pictionary. Charades, there's another one. Write down all the movies, books, titles, and all of that sort of stuff, song titles, on pieces of paper, put them in a hat, draw them out, and play charades. How many games can you come up with where you were, how many games that you can come up with that you use pen and paper for it, And then how about creating a new game with pen and paper? Maybe it could be, oh, it could even be creating a dart, you know, a paper airplane and decorating with the pen. See, there's ways around these things. So just have fun today with pen and paper and see what you can come up with. Maybe you just decide to sit down and write a story. Maybe write yourself a short story. Write a poem. There you go. Write a poem. There you go. This is a good challenge for you. So as a recap, your mindset today is all about rain, how it benefits your mind. Think about the different things, like when you hear rain, find ways to find it soothing and calming. Maybe some people might even find it creative because it's kind of like washing away the cobwebs. Your business is all about routines. Get into routines, put stuff into your calendars, but only put in the stuff that you're going to commit to. And then your fun challenge is all about pen and paper. How much fun can you have with a pen and a piece of paper? And how many games can you come up with that you can play with pen and paper? And how about creating a new one? That's it from me for now. Have a super fantastic sparkling day, and we will catch you guys this evening. Hei konera.